of people tonight. Maybe the catch of the year right there.
Cologne looking for his first hit of the year. Oh. He drives one deep left field. Back goes Upton. Back near the wall. It's out of here. Bartolo has done it. The impossible has happened.
This is one of the great moments in the history of baseball. Bartolo Cologne has gone deep.
20, 25 years from now, you're going to want to say, I was there when Ken Griffey Jr. made his home debut. So don't forget that on Monday night. There's a drive into the gap in left center field and deep left center field, and Henderson's not going to get to it. It's off the base of the wall, and Griffey to second base in his first major league at bat, a ringing double off the 375 marker, and we have seen that all spring. Welcome to the show, Ken Griffey Jr.
There's another drive. Deep down the line, he crushed another one. Up into the billboard for another three-run homer.
That's sick.
From Flushing, Queens, baseball from the home of the Mets, Citi Field. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. Stay tuned for Mets baseball coming up next. Robert Gsellman, a California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Harold, any thoughts?
Well, he has got an excellent strikeout-to-walk ratio. He's dominating hitters. He doesn't walk guys. He's around the plate. And that number alone just tells me his stuff is dominating and hitters can't catch up to it. Let's watch him execute in this game.
Now in the box, D. Gordon hitting just a bit over the Mendoza line on the year. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And here's a ball hit in the air. Cabrera onto the grass, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. And here's how the visiting Miami Marlins will line up in this one. Who do you have your eye on, Dan?
Well, Matt, we all know it. The man to watch, Giancarlo Stanton. He's got great power. I love watching a guy take the ball to the opposite field or go to dead center field, and that's exactly who he is. BP is impressive, and I wouldn't be surprised to see him launch one in this one.
Set to go now, Christian Yelich, and he's someone they're going to have to watch out for. You can see he's been a tough out over the last couple of series. Chopped foul over towards the dugout. Oh, look out, hot shot to third, and there are two away.
Third, right fielder
Giancarlo Stanton now. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Those 0-2 curveballs are really tough for guys to lay off. There's a reason it's such a common pitch in that count, but he did well to spit on it there.
He executed that 1-2 curveball pretty well. I think it's right where he wanted it.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So not much happening here in the top half of the first. Now the Mets will step up for their first shot in a scoreless ball game. Dan Straily gets the ball for Miami in this one. HR, what's the word on him?
Well, I look at his stat line, Matt. I look at his whip, and it's just above league average, and that tells me he struggles just a little bit this year. If he can keep runners off the base paths and not pile up a lot more than maybe the one or a little bit above an inning, then he's got a chance to win. So keeping the traffic limited is the key to his success in this game.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. This Marlins ball club, Harold Reynolds, as they begin play here tonight, they come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
Well, Matt, they're coming off winning a big game. I mean, they played great baseball. They scored a lot of runs in that win yesterday. So if they can carry that momentum over, they're going to be tough to beat.
A high fastball is in there.
We got full count.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact.
Well, he's out in front of that changeup. I'll tell you what, he had the honor of the fastball. The fastball, the pitch before and back with the changeup, that's a great combination.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Therefore, it is Stanton, and he's got it for the first out. With a moment here in Flushing Meadows, let's meet the Mets. How do they get back into the win column here, Harold?
Well, Matt, this is a very aggressive club. They steal a lot of bases. They're not at the top of the league, but, man, they're right there. They're not far behind. They will run at every opportunity they get to try to force mistakes.
Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. Batter pitcher numbers against Dan Straily. He's gone 2-for-5. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Tell you what, he's got a good changeup, and I love throwing the changeup right there. You got two strikes on the hitter. That ball coming out of the hand looks so much like a fastball with the same release, and then it ends up being a changeup. I like the pitch. Two-strike back foot slider. That's a classic pitch. Nice job of laying off of that.
Hit hard on the ground to second, and that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
Well, the leadoff guy couldn't get on, but the number two guy with that base hit gets on base. Now here comes the thunder, the meat of the order. This is what they want.
Here's the left fielder, Yoenis Cespedes. And what a season he's having. Entering play, leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew working this one. Behind the plate is Eric Summersgill.
Summersgill's a little notorious for having a wide zone. Really frustrating for hitters. I saw one guy turn around at him one day and yell, "Is this a picnic table or is it a plate?" Yeah, he was tossed before he finished the sentence.
Swung on and hit in the air to left. Ozuna is under it. And that's the second out of the inning. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Batting court.
Here's Jay Bruce now. He drove in his club's only run a night ago. Here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. A runner on first with two away. He's running toward second. Fouled back. Working for the punch out and the offering. And another foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. Hard ground ball to third. Up with it now is Prado. But the feet of the second baseman is a wild one. And they won't get him as he's able to advance from first to third on what would certainly be scored a throwing error.
And as a former pitcher, I can tell you, nothing is more painful than having to get extra outs in an inning. That should have been out number three there. Instead, he has to refocus and get back to work.
Standing in now, Wilmer Flores. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2.
Matt, in last night's game, this is the situation right here. They didn't do a very good job driving guys in with runners in scoring position. Right here, you got a guy in scoring position. You got to capitalize and drive in. If you swung at a bad pitch last night, get a good pitch to drive right here.
Stanton is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out of potential trouble. We played an inning, still nothing. Into the box, Justin Bour. And the home-away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Here it comes on 1-1. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Chopped weakly to the left. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the Mets. And I'm looking in the outfield at Jay Bruce. I love when they yell that name. The big time they yell it is when he does something exciting, like on the defensive side. He can catch and throw. I love watching him throw that pretty left-handed delivery on a strike to the plate.
Here's Marcell Ozuna. He also had three hits in the win last night. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Again, he sends it out of play.
I like the call for the two-strike changeup. You got to make a better pitch. He got away with one right there.
Now another 1-2. Swing, and that's hit out of play up into the plaza level. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
This guy's a good hitter. He's seen a lot of pitches already, fouling balls off. But as the pitcher, I got to keep throwing him strikes. And if he hits it, hopefully it's at somebody.
Now another 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
That was the fifth foul ball in this at-bat. He's seen a lot of pitches.
And he finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at-bat.
Batting second. Catcher.
Digging in, JT Realmuto took an 0-for-4 in the victory last night. The pitch. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
It's all a part of learning how to pitch in the big leagues. Major league hitters will not bail you out by swinging at pitches out of the zone. So he's going to have to continue to learn how to get guys out at this level.
2-1. HR, these Mets as they enter play here tonight. It was another loss last time out, and this portion of the schedule has not done them any favors as they've dropped 5 of their last 7.
Matt, there's some tough losses in the course of the season, right? We've all witnessed that. But, man, to lose a 1-run game when you're losing a lot recently, that just rips the heart.
And not in time as the run scores.
Great piece of hitting here. Men on first, and they're playing him to pull, but he crosses them up and goes the other way with it, making the outfielder cover a lot of extra ground. That allowed the runner to come all the way around from first to score, and that was a great piece of hitting.
Into the box, Adani Echevarria, and he puts it on the ground to second, and that's through into center field, base hit. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
Cardinals sin, Cardinals sin. You got an open base with the pitcher on the on-deck circle, and you let him get a base hit. That just can't happen.
Into the box now, Dan Straily. And this is low, ball 2. 2-1. 2 balls and a strike. Here it comes. A good knee-high changeup taken for a strike. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. So it's 2 runs on 2 hits, no errors, and a runner left. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Marlins 2 and the Mets nothing. Here's Neil Walker. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Outside, 2-1.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Well, he's out in front of that changeup. I think, Matt, that was a result of the fastball, the pitch before. He's throwing so hard, you got to honor that fastball in that situation.
And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. The 2-2 one more time. And the changeup is way low that time.
This is a really good at bat. This is the kind that you go back to the dugout, regardless of the outcome, they go, great AB, man, great AB.
Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. Fouled back.
That is the fourth foul ball of this AB right here. He's seeing a lot of pitches.
The 3-2 one more time. Hit hard up the middle. That gets through, and he'll start the inning off with a base hit. So with that, the Mets have a runner aboard to get the inning underway.
Well, a leadoff single right here in the second inning. This is a good sign. Maybe this is how they get right back in the game, being already down a couple of runs early.
Here's Lucas Duda now. The average just a few ticks shy of 300 for the season. So perhaps a hit or two in this one could put him up over the top. Now the 0-2 pitch. Two strike pitch is chopped foul at the plate and will do it again. And he swings here and sends one in the air deep down the right field line. And this will wind up being nothing more than a long foul ball, and it'll hold the count at 0-2. And a good idea to hold off on that swing. It's ball one.
Boy, a check swing on a pitch way out of the zone. Just held up, but boy, as a pitcher, you're hoping that he swings at that one.
And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. To Gordon for one. On to first, and they get them both.
Hey, doesn't come much easier than that. Taylor made 6-4-3 double play and an easy one to turn.
Now at the plate, Rene Rivera will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. One and one, here it comes. A fastball that just misses inside.
Didn't catch the corner there, but you can see he was trying to jam in with that running action on that two-seam fastball.
A big pass at a slider that gets past him. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit on the ground to third. Prado is there. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. We'll go now to the top of the third. The Marlins on top, 2-0. Here's D. Gordon now. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play in the National League's Eastern Division race. In is Christian Yelich, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted.
Now batting, right fielder.
So bases are empty here with 2 gone. And set to stand in the ultra-dangerous Giancarlo Stanton. And he finally gets this one over for strike one.
Well, I thought with 2 outs right there, that situation, he probably had the green light 3-0. Maybe he didn't get it where he wanted.
He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. So they breeze through this half of the inning. We'll head now to the home half of inning number 3. The Marlins lead this one 2-0. Leading off the inning, Robert Gsellman, and they'll need him to get something going here. Favorable call in there for a strike.
One ball, 2 strikes, you count.
Ready on 1-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Echevarria has it. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. And with that, we give you a look at what's happening in the NL East race.
Granderson.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And standing in now is the dangerous center fielder, Curtis Granderson. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Takes a knee-high fastball. One out, nobody on. Here's a high foul ball as it finds a lucky fan in the upper deck for a souvenir. Hit down the line at first, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. The 1-2 pitch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. 1-2, here it comes. And a neck-high fastball that time.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
Stanton has a long run, but he takes charge for out number two.
The shortstop, number 13.
Digging in for his second at bat, Asdrubal Cabrera, a base hit in his first trip. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that misses, 2-1. Now the pitch. 2-1 pitch, a circle change taken for a called strike two. Now Cabrera awaits the 2-2. Pulled toward right center field. After it is Yelich. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Mets go down 1-2-3. They're down 2-0. Striding in once again, Justin Bour. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Here it comes on nothing and two. Fouled straight back.
Well, I think he's trying to get that two-strike fastball out of the zone. Just caught too much of the plate right there. Fortunately, he fouled it off instead of putting it in the seats.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Lifted the other way out to left center. Granderson is under it. One down. So with the fly out there coming on the fastball, seems like an appropriate time to check out our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And both guys topping out so far in the low 90s, 93 for one guy, 91 for the other. Two balls and a strike, here it comes. Hit hard to third. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Well, he picks up a hit now in 11 straight games. Swinging the bat pretty good. I love the adjustments he's made along the way through this whole streak.
David Wright will come in as the new third baseman now following the injury.
Now playing third base, number 5, David Wright.
Stepping in now, JT Realmuto. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Two runs, three hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul.
I like the pitch right there. Got it to chase a fastball out of the zone. I'd come back with it again.
Another one sent foul.
He's just fouling them off till he gets something he wants to hit.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Another foul ball, and this battle will continue. Another 1-2 delivery. Got him.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1-2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
In now, Martin Prado. And he puts it on the ground to second. Walker has it. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. One left for Miami as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Here's the left fielder, Yoenis Cespedes. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Looks like a left-hander up and throwing now in that Marlins bullpen. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. There's a changeup over the outside corner. Hard hit at third. Prado's throw to first gets him one away.
Now batting. Right fielder. Shane.
Digging in to try it again. Jake Bruce. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. No walks yet. Here's the delivery. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. Once again, a 3-2. Hard hit ball to second. Backhanded. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. It was a fastball right down the middle, and he hit it hard, but he couldn't elevate it at all. Would have been a different story if he did.
Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Down in order go the Mets. They trail it here 2-0. Ready for another chance? Adani Echevarria. He'll start off the fifth in this one. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Swing and a looper to left. Here comes Cespedes. He's there and records the first down. Now at the plate, Dan Straily. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. Two runs, three hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. Here's another 1-2. To the right side, but foul, and he'll try it again. Again, a 1-2. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
I really like watching righties throw that cutter in on lefty's hands like that. This one was down two, and if he hits it, there's a pretty good chance he's going to pound it into the ground. Maybe even give himself a shin burger.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Payoff pitch one more time. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. He spoils another one, and we'll do it again. Another full count pitch home. A swing, and it's popped in the air back behind first. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
That is what every hitting coach in the game teaches you to do. Don't ever try and do too much with a pitch. Just use the whole field and go with the pitch wherever you can. Pushes it down the line, and it bounces over for a ground rule double.
Standing in now, D. Gordon. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Set, and the 2-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. Walker's got it. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting.
Digging in once again, Christian Yelich. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Marlins lead one, but they're on top 2-0. Jeff Locke is going to take over now here in inning number five, so it'll be a bullpen game from here on out.
Jeff Locke.
Neil Walker will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
Well, this offense finds themselves struggling right now, and they're down a few runs. They got to try to manufacture, get somebody on, maybe hit and run, and then you look for the big ball. Looks like right now everybody's swinging for the downs. They got to turn it around a little bit. Play a little small ball. Get it going.
The first baseman, number 21.
Here's Lucas Duda now. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Two balls and a strike. Here it is.
Hey.
Looks at a two-seamer right down the middle.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle center cut. Tough pitch to take.
And this is down at knee level as it's chopped foul at home plate. A swinging bunt to the mound. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now batting, catcher, Rene
stepping
Rivera.
In, Rene Rivera. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Lock gets the sign. 1-1 on its way. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
Now, Matt, this is the tough part of being the eight hitter. That ball's right down the middle. So it makes me wonder, is he trying to give his pitcher a breather, or is he just not being aggressive? With the pitcher hitting behind you, you get a ball groove, you got to take a big hat.
Two out, nobody on. Swing and a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. And Daney will make the catch to retire the side. So they go quietly here in this half inning. Five innings complete. It's the Marlins 2 and the Mets nothing. Fernando Salas will come on in relief now as he'll make his 10th appearance of the season.
Fernando Salas.
Riding in once again, Giancarlo Stanton in his career against this pitcher, 0-for-5. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. Nearly a big fly to start the inning, instead a foul ball. Now here's the pitch. Drill down the line, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. The next 3-2. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The payoff pitch one more time. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Now batting. The first baseman, Justin.
Digging in once again, Justin Bohr. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. Into the upper deck, but foul. Bases are empty, one man out. Squared that one up just a little late. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Lined foul right over the Mets dugout. Another try at 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. Oh, and this goes right past him. Another multi-hit game for him here tonight. No surprise there as we take a look at the league leaders in hitting. And as you see there, he sits in fourth place in that department in the National League. Digging in to try it again, JT Realmuto, 0-for-1 with a run scored thus far. Two out with the man at first. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there, base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Breaking his heart, Matt. Breaking his heart. He got two quick outs. He's thinking he's going to cruise through this thing. And now look at him. Boom, boom, base hits coming back at you. That's why you have to complete the inning.
Ready for another chance, Martin Prado. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. This one's down to third. Throw on to first to be in time, and the Marlins can't cash in here, and that ends the inning. Marlins strand a pair. They're up 2-0. Jose Reyes is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six.
Jose Reyes.
Hit back toward the mound, and that's going to be a base hit. So a great job off the bench as he's aboard to kick off their half of the inning.
When you're struggling, you'll look for anything. Been off to a little bit of a cold streak. He didn't hit it hard, but that's a big one to build on.
Here's the center fielder Curtis Granderson. His lifetime batting line with Jeff Locke, not great. He's 1-for-8. A runner at first with no outs here. Sure enough, there goes Reyes. Swing hard liner to left center. And Granderson will be aboard with a base hit. And he's safe.
Well, they start the runner, get things moving, and create holes. And the hitter jumps on one and slaps it through the hole on the left side. When you move runners, it just opens up the infield because the infield is out of position. Nice job.
Into the box as Drubal Cabrera. He swings and grounds it to short. To Gordon for one. On to first, and it's a double play, although the run does come into score from third.
It certainly looked like they might have had a big inning cooking there with first and third and no outs, but the double play kind of kills it. They did get the run in, but the batter doesn't get credit for an RBI.
Stepping in now, Yoenis Cespedes. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Stanton giving chase. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. Mets played a run on a couple of hits. Seventh inning coming up. Miami's out in front, 2-1. Welcome back to Citi Field in Flushing. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. Josh Edgen will come on in relief now as he'll make his 10th appearance of the season.
Josh Edgen.
Here's Echevarria now. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Now here's the pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Played on the backhand. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
And this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
Ichiro Suzuki will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning.
Ichiro Suzuki.
And this is fouled at the plate. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
Up next for the Marlins, second baseman.
Digging in, D. Gordon. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Ready with the 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Swing and a line drive, but this is a foul ball.
That is too good a pitch to make right there with two strikes, but he fouled it off. Now you got to stay aggressive and go get him again.
Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Here he comes again, 1-2. Grounded up the first baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. He'll try again, 1-2. This is swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. And Wright will make the catch to retire the side. Jay Bruce will be the one to lead us off when we return. It's the Marlins 2 and the Mets 1. Brian Ellington gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seven.
Brian Ellington.
Here's Jay Bruce now. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. And he just misses with a curveball. And the pitch on 2-1. Lifted in the air out to center field. Yelich is under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Third baseman, number 5.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, David Wright. He's 0-1 thus far. Here's the 1-1 pitch, and he gets under this one as the ball is skied into very shallow right. Gordon takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
The batter.
Second. Here's Neil Walker. He's 1-2 in the ball game. Now the pitch. And he drops a change in on him there, and that'll run it full, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
The 3-2 one more time. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Stanton has a read on it. And that retires the side. Mets go down 1-2-3. They still trail it here 2-1. Digging in now, Christian Yelich. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Ready on 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here it comes. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back.
Oh, he's clearly hitting off the fastball right there. You don't hit one that hard if you're not looking for it.
This is popped high in the air toward the right side of the infield. Therefore, it is Duda, and he's got it one away. Giancarlo Stanton now, 0-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And a base hit as that's into left, and they've got themselves a base runner.
No respect. They know you're struggling, so they came right at you with the fastball, 3-2, and you got the base hit. That's got to make you feel pretty good.
Justin Ward.
And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets' bullpen. Into the box now, Justin Bohr. Slice down the left side, but foul. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Lifted the other way to left center. And plenty of room out there for Granderson, and there are 2 away now. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
How about it? Left fielder, Marcell Ozuna.
Here's Marcell Ozuna. 2 hits and 3 at-bats for him in this one. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. 1 left for Miami that they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead.
Your attention, please.
Now new pitcher set to take over here, and we'll see the right-hander, Junichi Tozawa.
Junichi Tozawa.
Ready once again, Lucas Duda. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. Full count, here it comes. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Gordon is there, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out.
Now batting, catcher.
Now at the plate, Rene Rivera. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Here he comes on a ball and 2 strikes. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number 2. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
This is pulled into right, and that'll get down for a 2-out single.
That ball is above the zone. He got his hands on top of it. The old tomahawk. They got a base hit out of it.
Granderson.
In now, Curtis Granderson. And this is fouled back and out of play. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Now another 1-2. Hit pretty well out to deep left field. Ozuna racing back. No chance to make a play here as this one's off the wall, and this could tie the game. And a relay to the plate. And he can't hang on to the ball here at home plate.
I love the late inning at bats when you come up clutch right there. Big hit to tie this game.
Asdrubal.
So striding forward now, Asdrubal Cabrera. He was a double play victim last time around. One pitch coming now to Cabrera. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
Man, I just think he's pitching scared. Look, he's getting hit a little bit, and now he's falling behind another hitter. Challenge somebody.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two. Looking for the K. Here's the pitch. Liner towards second, but this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it to end the inning. One for the Mets here on the RBI double. On to the ninth inning from Citi Field, and we're dead deadlock now at two apiece. The 7 train making its stops just outside Citi Field as we welcome you back inside for the remainder of baseball on the show. Jerry Spamilia comes on now, and he's just hoping to keep this thing tied. No save opportunity here.
Jerry Spamilia.
Digging in and looking for more, JT Realmuto, lifetime against Spamilia, 0-11. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with 3 quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
And this ball runs away for ball 2. 2-1. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first 2 men he faces out of the bullpen.
The batter, number 3. Shortstop.
Ready for another shot now. Adani Echevarria. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. A line drive over the head of Cabrera and on into left center for a base hit.
That's an impressive swing on a tough pitch, a sinker from a right-handed pitcher going into the right-handed batter, and he's able to get the bat head out and hit it to the left field. That was really cool.
Derek Dietrich will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Derek Dietrich.
Hard hit ball to second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Marlins lead 1. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. David Phelps enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings. Here's Yoenis Cespedes. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Swing and a line drive, but foul. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. But this is yanked down out there at shortstop for the first out. Here's Jay Bruce now. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. 1 out, nobody on. And that's taken for a called strike 2.
He might want that pitch back up and away. That's a pitch you can really drive if you have the right approach towards that opposite field gap.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Back goes Ozuna to the track. Gone! Santa Maria, game over. A solo shot there for Jay Bruce. And with 1 swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Well, they say better late than never, and that's obviously something that he takes to heart as he puts a charge in 1 for a walk-off homer. Got to be the best feeling in all of baseball.
And guys, time to recognize the man who really stood out this afternoon, and there he is, Jay Bruce. Thanks largely to one heroic swing, he's our top player of the game.
Well, the numbers don't just jump out at you, but his lone hit was a really important one. And sometimes you just need to come through when it matters most to be the hero, and he did just that.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Jerry's Familia claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that just about does it for Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, and our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.
Final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious New York Mets, 3 runs on 7 hits. No errors. We left 3 men on base.
10th inning, 3-3. Dodgers and Rockies. 0-1 to Charlie.
Swung on a high fly ball to deep left field. The Dodgers have been empties. If you believe a home run, and the Dodgers have clinched the division and will celebrate on schedule. Leave it to the Dodgers. Charlie Culberson, a game-winning home run. What a moment to have it. And